Welcome back to the channel, and this is Whatever Happened To. In this episode, we're talking the Wizard of Oz theme park. Growing up in Kansas City, there were rumors of a new theme park based around the legendary film, The Wizard of Oz. I first heard of the idea in the 90s, but at some point in the 2000s, the idea quickly faded away. All right, let's take a trip down the Yellow Brick Road and find out what happened. Our story begins in 1985.
As a kid growing up in Kansas City, The Wizard of Oz has a special place in my heart. The theme of leaving your small town in search of a big dream and a magical place, it spoke to me. Dorothy's red slippers are iconic and known worldwide. Does anybody remember the film Return to Oz? This film was the inspiration for local entrepreneurs in the Kansas area to propose a Wizard of Oz theme park. In 1985, David Landis, president of the Emerald City and Yellow Brick Road Productions, proposed an idea for a $20 million, 60-acre Land of Oz amusement park to be located at 87th Street and Interstate 435, which would have been the largest theme park in the region and would have rivaled Disneyland in size. So whatever happened? Yet by 1990, when Overland Parker Burton Stonefield proposed an Oz park for Wyandotte County, Landis had not made any progress in Lenexa. During that time, a competing plan based in Linn County, Kansas, about 60 miles south of Johnson County, was grander. It included a $100 million movie studio, a theme park, a shopping center, a hotel on more than 1,000 acres of land. Led by George Soule of Kansas City, Missouri, the group pitched the film studio as Halfway to Hollywood, while a theme park located on the site would be called Land of Oz. By 1990, the Linn County plan had also died, and one of the principal investors was in jail on two counts of selling unregistered securities for soliciting $10,000 in investments. So, to dive a little bit deeper into the characters and the people who were actually behind the original plan, we're going to talk about Gus Passone, Robert Corey, and David Owens. Key members of the wonderful Wizard of Oz plan: August, Gus C. Passone, Robert Corey, Dave Owens all had financial and criminal pasts, failed previous projects, and mismanaged businesses. Owen dropped out of the project after he was indicted for tax fraud in an unrelated matter. Corey and Fasson first partnered on the Sandstone Amphitheater project. This project suffered from mismanagement, financial distress, and a bailout with taxpayer funds. Corey and Fasson teamed up again on the renovation of Memorial Hall in KCK. This project also suffered from mismanagement and financial distress before the city sued World Entertainment to cease operations. Gus Fasson had a storied past, including arrests, several FBI investigations, and a business storefront destroyed by a bomb blast in 1970. Altogether, that plan, the projected cost was $200 million. So in October 1992, the company was renamed Oz Resorts and Entertainment Company, led by Corey. The cost for the next idea was $300 million. The park was to occupy 55 acres, but was eyeing 900 acres to eventually develop for other projects. A 300-room hotel, a golf course, an RV park, a lake, and a shopping district. The Oz Park would contain 6 theme areas. So here's all the areas included. The Haunted Forest, which was to be themed around the Wicked Witch of the West. And of course, a gleaming Emerald City. By 1988, a third plan was pitched called White Winds, located in the Ozarks. This plan would have been slightly smaller than the idea before, just 630 acres, and was scheduled to be completed in 3 years, costing around $400 million. This play geared away from the Wizard of Oz theme, although the main focal point was a section of the park called the Land of Oz. So going into the 1990s, we already have three plans, three different locations spanning across both state lines from Kansas to Missouri. And every plan has a ballooning budget. You would think this would be a no-brainer idea for the region.
That's the trouble. I can't make up my mind.
But with all the plans and crazy budgets, all the counties involved were somehow still on board. So what were the factors that ultimately got in the way and put this Land of Oz theme park to bed? By the mid-1990s, the excitement of the theme park grew thin. And by 1995 and 96, there were no new developments at all.
Who said that?
So I'm going to walk you through kind of a bullet point of what kind of killed the Oz theme park idea. So Oz Group had not purchased a single acre of land in Wyandotte County by 1997.
That's funny. Wasn't he pointing the other way?
Two, which is now the Kansas Speedway, was an alternative project proposal at the time. March 1994, there was talk of adding a casino, which immediately lost favor and support within the Kansas legislature. Skip Palmer, which was now the president of the whole investment group that was to develop the park, he said developers will remain committed to working with Kansas City, Kansas. They were, in fact, at the time, looking at a possible alternative site. Five, the new site, which they had their eyes on, Sunflower AAP, boasted 9,065 continuous acres and was in proximity to population centers and major traffic routes. Six, the new land was problematic. It was heavily contaminated and needed environmental remediation, meaning it was going to cost a whole lot of money to get this land fixed and ready for a theme park. The land was deemed unusable. The total cleanup cost was $30 to $40 million.
Wait a minute, fellas. I was just thinking. I really don't want to see the wizard this much. I better wait for you outside.
So who's to blame for finally putting a nail in the coffin on the Wizard of Oz theme park? If I were to pick one single person to blame, I would say it's the original investment group that proposed the plan in the beginning for not having any follow-through. They didn't even purchase any land in the area. So with all that said, during the 1970s, there was a place in North Carolina that actually had a theme park, I guess what you can call a theme park, actually constructed, and it actually opened to a small crowd of about 25,000 people at the time. The Land of Oz was never much of a theme park. It had a ski lift and an outdoor amphitheater with landmarks dedicated to the film. It closed in the 1980s. So in closing, the Wizard of Oz theme park, I wish it had happened. It would have been great for the area. It sounded like, you know, it would have been a great plan. All the proposed plans were pretty huge in scale. I mean, man, well, whatever happened to the Wizard of Oz theme park?
Dare to dream, really do.